Good morning and welcome to worship. We're going to begin this morning with a hymn. He is King of Kings. It's hymn number 273 in your hymnals if you want to follow along, and the lyrics will be up on the screen.
Grace and peace to you from our Lord Jesus Christ. Welcome to this service of worship. As we gather today, I have a couple of announcements. Today, the youth group is going ice skating, and if you would like to come and be with the youth group, that's great. We're going to go to the Shenley Rink. We usually go downtown, but Shenley Rink today. So Shenley Rink, we're going to meet here at 1. If you want to ride out with us, or you can just meet us out there for the session that starts at 1:30. I think that there are still tickets available for the preschool fundraiser. Does anybody have tickets here? Nobody has tickets here. So there might be some tickets available. Erlina May has 2 tickets available. If you are leading a church ministry, we hope that your annual report is already done and in Kate and Nicole's hands. If it's not, then let's see about getting it there. This week, Ash Wednesday, our Lent service begins. This coming Wednesday worship will be at 7. We will, during that worship service, we will be seeing some pictures and hearing some stories about the Texas mission trip that just finished. If you'd like to hear what has happened in the Texas trip. Before that, we'll have a potluck dinner on Ash Wednesday at 6 o'clock, and I will be bringing grapefruit pie as a memento of our Texas trip. And also, at the Wednesday service, we will be offering the imposition of ashes as well as the Lord's Supper. If you can't come to worship, but you would like to receive ashes, you can do that. I'll be here from 7 to 7:30 Wednesday morning over the lunch hour on Wednesday, like 11:30 to 1, and then from 5 to 6. So if for some reason you can't make worship, but you want ashes, stop by during the day. There's blood drive next week. And also next week, we're going to start a new small group. meeting Jesus at the table. It's going to be a Lenten theme. It's a six-week conversation. We'll be down in the conference room, and you don't have to buy a book. You don't have to read a book. I'll be using this to help prompt some of our conversation, and we will be a small group Bible study looking at some of the passages of Scripture where Jesus spoke some of the most amazing truths in the context of a meal. So that'll be next Wednesday. And the last announcement I have is to extend a welcome back to Kenny Stockard, who has become a friend of many of us. I'm glad for the program that Kenny and Lucas have worked on. You'll hear more about that as we go along. But thanks for being here, gentlemen. We really appreciate that. I don't think there are further announcements, so I will at this point invite you to stand as Hannah calls us into worship.
The mountaintop, the shining face, the glowing clothes, the voice of God speaking from the cloud, the commandments etched in stone.
Sometimes God shows up in ways we cannot deny. In a place we can go, a light we can see, a voice we can hear, a stone we can touch.
Sometimes
there is the veil, the overshadowing, terrifying cloud.
Sometimes there are questions, the appearing and disappearing, the excitement, the wondering, or the silence.
Sometimes God shows up in ways we can't quite figure out.
Always God shows up somehow. So we have shown up, O Lord, here and now. We have come to look for the ways that you are active in the world today.
There's a lot in our lives that is not the way that we wish that it was or that we know that it ought to be. There's a lot in our world that is broken and that needs to be set aside or repaired or mended or made whole or healed. In church, we use the word confession to mean a couple of different things. One of the things that we mean now is that it's good for us every now and again to sit in front of the Lord and to say, this is what is broken. This is how it is. This is what's not right. And the Christian word for not right is sin. This is where things are just messed up. And sometimes it's stuff we've done, sometimes it's stuff that we've had to walk through. But we've all been there this week. And I would invite you to join me in using the printed prayer in front of you and then to walk into a time of silent and personal confession. Let's pray together. Eternal God, we confess that we have praised you with our lips, but have not glorified you with our lives. Have mercy on us, we pray, for our weak faith that fades under pressure, for our quick enthusiasm that just as quickly dies, for the hopes we proclaim but do not pursue. God's people continue together. Forgive us, Lord God, and give us new trust in your power, that we may live for justice and tell of your loving kindness by our acts as by our words. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Beloved, the God who challenges us is also the God who encourages us. The God who confronts us is also the God who accepts us. Be assured that God is with us even now, accepting, guiding, and forgiving. Thanks be to God.
Pray. Holy God, you revealed to the disciples the everlasting glory of Jesus Christ. Grant us who have not seen and yet believe the gift of your Holy Spirit, that we may boldly live the gospel and shine with your transforming glory as people changed and changing through the redeeming presence of our Savior. Amen. The gospel reading for today comes from Matthew chapter 17, verses 1 through 9. After 6 days, Jesus took with him Peter, James, and John, the brother of James, and led them up a high mountain by themselves. There he was transfigured before them. His face shone like the sun, and his clothes became as white as the light. Just then there appeared before them Moses and Elijah, talking with Jesus. Peter said to Jesus, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you wish, I will put up 3 shelters, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While he was still speaking, a bright cloud covered them, and a voice from the cloud said, "This is my son, whom I love. With him I am well pleased. Listen to him." When the disciples heard this, they fell face down to the ground, terrified. But Jesus came and touched them. "Get up," he said. "Don't be afraid." When they looked up, they saw no one except Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, Jesus instructed them, "Don't tell anyone what you have seen until the Son of Man has been raised from the dead." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I'd like to invite children to come forward for just a few minutes, please. Good morning. All right, Becca's first visit up front. Good morning, good morning. I'm happy to see you all today. Say that again. Leah, I'm glad you're here. I'm Pastor Dave. And you brought snuggly friends with you, didn't you? They're lovely. As we start today, we're doing things a little bit different in church today, and you'll see what I mean in just a minute. I'm thinking about praying. Can you think, are there times at your house when you say prayers or when you pray, or are there places where you have been praying? What do you think, Jim? Okay, going to bed. Does anybody else pray at bedtime? Some of us do. Are there other times you've seen people? What do you think? Okay, so say a grace before a meal. Has anybody ever had a prayer before a meal? Some of us do that. Did you have something else that you wanted to add, Brogan? Okay, so before lunch? Yep, before lunch, before dinner. We pray lots of different ways. Sometimes, I don't know about you, but sometimes when I pray, I close my eyes and I put my hands together, and it helps me to think. But sometimes I pray when I'm driving. And when I'm driving and I'm praying, I don't close my eyes, which is a good thing, right? I keep my eyes open. Sometimes we pray when people are sick. Today, well, let me ask you this. When you pray at a meal, do you pray a prayer that you always pray the same thing, like, "Come, Lord Jesus, be our guest," or does somebody make up a prayer? Okay, so it's a made-up prayer. Sometimes we use the same one, like, I don't know what you say when you go to bed, Judah, but sometimes I used to say, "Now I lay me down to sleep." Anybody hear a prayer that begins like that? Sometimes we use words that we just come right from us. Sometimes we use words that come from someplace else. Someone else has done it. A long, long time ago, a man who lived in Africa, and his name was, he was called Augustine. Augustine said, "Whoever sings prays twice." Anybody who sings prays twice. Today, instead of me getting up there and talking about what the Bible passage was about, my friend Mr. Kenny is going to get up and he's going to sing. And while he's singing, I hope that you can think of that as a prayer, because most of the words in the songs are really prayers, and some of them are from hundreds of years before I was born or before you were born, but they're still true today because they help us. So when we pray the prayers with Mr. Kenny this morning, I want us to think of, he's praying, we're praying with him, but we're also praying with all those people who 50 or 100 or 200 years ago prayed those same prayers for God's love, God's power, God's justice to come and be part. I hope I have a hunch you're going to like the songs that Mr. Kenny sings. And I hope that they touch you inside and help you to feel better about your praying to God today. Let us pray now, and we'll pray for Mr. Kenny and for the songs that we're going to hear, okay? We thank you, God, that you allow us to be together. We thank you that you give us voices to use, ears to hear, and words to sing. We pray for Mr. Kenny and ask that you would bless him in his singing. We pray with all the people who wrote those songs so long ago that you would help us to understand who you are and how your world works better. Thank you for this day. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, there's no children's program today because we're all going to be together to hear Mr. Kenny, okay? So you can go back to the people that brought you.
Okay, you guys can hear me okay? Here we go. Are you guys excited to be here this morning? I'm really excited to be here. How you doing? I'm really excited to be here today, and I'm really excited about doing this concert. This is the first time that we've done this concert since the last time we were in this church, actually. So normally we do more of these at other places, but this year, you got us last, you got us first. Cool? All right. Starting off with, I wish I knew how it feels, how it would feel to be free. I wish that I knew how it feels to be free. I wish I could break all these chains binding me. I wish I could say all the things that I should say. Say them loud, say them clear, for the whole world to hear. I wish I could share all the love in my heart. Remove all the bars that still keep us apart. I wish you could know what it means to be me, then you see and agree that every man should be free. I wish I could give like I'm longing to give. I wish I could live like I'm longing to live. I wish I could do all the things I can do, and though I'm way overdue, I'd be starting anew. I wish I could be like a bird in the sky. How sweet it would be if I found I could fly. Then I soar to the sky and look down at the sea. Then I would sing. I'd sing. Then I would sing. I wish I could sing.
I would sing, I would sing, then I would sing, 'cause I know how it feels to be
I was telling Lucas, good job, and he was about to start the next song. I'm like, I'm not ready, hold on. This next song, you guys have done it in a hymnal earlier today. We did Ride on King Jesus, so it'll sound a little bit familiar, which is good. But yes, it's hard to read, so I'm gonna be looking at this paper a lot, so forgive me if I don't look at you for this one. All right, here we go. You ready? Let's do it.
Ride on, King Jesus, no man can hinder me. Ride on, King Jesus, ride on, no man can hinder me. Ride on, King Jesus, no man can hinder me. Gonna hinder me. For he is King of Kings, he is Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man works like him. For he is King of Kings, he is Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, the first and last, no man works like him. King Jesus rides a milk white horse, no man works like him. The river of Jordan, he did frost, no man works like him. For he is King of Kings, he is Lord of Lords. Oh, Jesus Christ, the first and last. Oh, King Jesus rides in the middle of the air. Oh, he calls his saints from everywhere. Oh, ride on, King Jesus, no man can hinder. Ride on, no man can hinder me. He is the King, he is the Lord. Oh, he is the King, he is the Lord. Oh, Jesus Christ, the first and last. No man works like him. Ride on, ride on, ride on, ride on, Jesus.
Let's give it up for Lucas, because that song is really hard to play also. Moving on to some of my favorites in this show, concert.
Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Upon that mountain, my Lord spoke out of his mouth. looked all around me, it looked so fine. I asked the Lord, could it be mine? Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Jordan River, chilly and cold, it chills the body but not the soul. There ain't but one train on this track, it runs to heaven and then right back. Oh, every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Yes, every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Yes, every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will pray. Moving in my heart, I will pray. Y'all want to clap? Come on. Moving in my heart, I will pray. 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 Yes, every time I feel the Spirit moving in my heart, I will, I'll pray.
Always, we're talking about praying. There's always a prayer on my heart. Anytime I have to sing, I'm just like praying, Lord, let me have a little more breath than I actually took in. And I'm just like, always trying to go the little extra mile, but it's okay. He knows how important that prayer is to me, and he sees us. Isn't that something, Pastor Dave, like something that's cool about prayer, that there's no prayer that's too small, and that every prayer counts, and every prayer is stored for eternity. They don't expire, so it's like really nice that I can pray anything I want in God. He cares and he sees, you know? You agree, you know about him, I love it. Okay, what's the next song? Give Me, oh yeah, that's a good one, that's a good one. I don't think we've done Give Me Jesus with this congregation before, and it's new to our program in general, but it's a spiritual that means a lot to me, and I think that it's powerful. I think it's in your hymnal, but I'm not sure. Don't quote me. Don't search for it. I don't think it's in there. But it's a hymn-type song. It can be in hymnals. But okay, let's do it. Give me Jesus.
was my cry. Dark midnight was my cry. Give me Jesus. Give me Jesus. Nobody but Jesus.
Powerful song. It's a really powerful song, and it's a very clear prayer of just like when it all is said and done, that's the only thing that my heart will be asking for when it's that time. Give me Jesus, even in the morning. I love that. The first verse, it says, in the morning when I rise. The second verse says, dark midnight was my cry. And so it's just going from like first thing in the morning to like situationally, like if when you're going through something, give me Jesus. And in the end, give us Jesus. I love that.
All right. I think this is appropriate.
We're going to do a little bit of Amazing Grace. I think that this is appropriate. We didn't plan to make those messages align, but I love how we can sing about his grace right after singing about all of the times that we pray to him and need him and call on him.
That taught my heart. that grace draw near. The hour I first believed, through many dangers, dangerous toils and snares, I have already come. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I'm found, was blind, but now
amazing grace. We're going to go through these next couple a little fast because I think one or two songs more than we did before. And so I might not talk through between these next couple, but just go for it, okay? All right. This is, Pastor Dad, this is when I fight using the microphone. It comes every year, right? At some point, I'm going to fight using this microphone. I'll use it, but I'll stand down here. Is that okay? We don't normally do that one, but I thought it fit. I thought it fit with the message. Just also a prayer just born out of the African American experience. If you don't know, that song is by Sam Cooke. I think it originally came out in the late early 60s. But yeah, change is gonna come. And I think we have seen a lot of change since the 60s, and we will continue to see change. If we keep praying and we keep believing, and eventually we'll all be on the other side where we won't have to deal with this anymore, right? Amen. I'm looking forward to that. All right. Sometimes I feel discouraged and think how deep I feel the pain. In prayer to the Holy Spirit revives my soul again. There is a balm in Gilead to if you cannot pray like Peter, and you cannot be like Paul, go home and tell your neighbors that he died to save us all. There is a bomb. We're going to invite you guys now to stand with us, and we're going to turn in our hymnals to 339, Lift Every Voice and Sing. And if it's okay with you, I'm not going to like particularly try to lead this song. We're just going to sing it together, okay? It'll be easier that way for me. All right. You about to jump in? Anybody else want to jump in on this? Feel free. It's a real joy to be at your church because when your pastor says good morning, you guys respond. I'm not knocking any other church, but at my church, they're very reflective and contemplative, so they don't speak back enough, in my opinion. But so I appreciate it when he spoke this morning. You guys were like, well, good morning. I'm like, it is, right? It is a good morning, right? All right. Everybody ready? Does anybody know this song already? It's a great song. It's also known as the Negro National Anthem. That's not a derogatory way to say that. Just in case you were wondering, that is the appropriate term. Cool? Is that cool? All right, cool. All right, we got one last song for you, and then we'll be done with this version of prayer in the service. And then I'm a little down, Dave, because this is the first time there wasn't a baptism. Supposed to be every year I've come here, there was a baptism, and this year we don't have a baptism. Come on, baptize those kids. All right.
When they crucified my Lord, were you there when they crucified my Lord? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified our Lord? Were you there when that stone was rolled away. Were you there when that stone was rolled away? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when that stone was rolled away? When that stone was rolled away, were you there when that stone was rolled away? Sometimes it causes me to tremble. Were you there when the stone, it was rolled away? Get happy about it, it's okay. Were you there when that stone was, it was rolled away? Were you there when that stone was rolled away? Lucas Bowman, thank you, Pastor Dave. Thank you guys for inviting us up here again. Seriously, I appreciate it. Turning it over now.
Friends, we're going to keep praying, and I have a few joys and concerns to share. If you have others to add, I'd invite you to if you're watching online, add them to the Facebook feed or just mention them to me after worship, and we will include them in the life of our congregation as we move forward. I would invite you to pray for Phyllis Nez Paul, that's Eva's mother-in-law, Raina's grandma, who's hospitalized today, and they're concerned for her health. Continue to pray for Marianne Richardson. Pray for the Castillo family, the family that we served in Texas this week, and you'll hear more about that on Wednesday. And then I would also just note that in Pennsylvania, one of our senators checked himself into the hospital this week to seek treatment for depression, John Fetterman. And I want to applaud Mr. Fetterman's bravery for being public about his diagnosis and about his seeking self-care. And I would just urge any of you who, if you feel that you've had something that's just not right, something that's hitting you in a tough way, it's okay to get help, and help can be found. And I would invite you and encourage you. If you're not sure where to turn, you can talk to me. I would encourage you to pray for Mr. Fetterman and for all who are held prisoner in this place of depression. Again, if you have things to share, I'd invite you to mention them to me afterwards. Other than that, let's pray. We give you thanks, God, that you have reached into our world, that you have given us songs to sing, that you have given us sometimes these melodies are hard and they are heavy and they are tough to bear. But we thank you that you have got us through and that there are people who will stand with us and sing with us. We thank you, too, for those places where there is light and joy and hope, where there is new construction, where it might not have existed before. We ask that you would walk with us as individuals, as this congregation, and as your whole people throughout the world, that we might be about being the change that we hope we can see in the world. Thank you for the gifts that we have already seen this morning and for those that we believe will show up in our lives at different points today. Bless, we pray, the work of your people, the work of the healing ministry of your church, and guide us in ways of faithfulness. We pray all of these things in Jesus' name and for his sake, and we use the words that he gave us as we pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
And now, not because we have to, but because we are grateful, let us return to God what is ours to share. Let us joyfully offer our time, our treasure, our commitment, our prayers. Those who are worshiping online will find instructions on the screen. Let us pray. Lord, I was a pile of ash, and you made me a light for the world. I was a stone, and you made me salt for the earth. I was as lifeless as clay, and you made me part of the body of Christ. I was sinful, and you made me holy. I was nothing, and you made me part of everything. Lord, in you I am transformed and transformed still again. When the discouraged cry for hope, make me hope. When the hungry cry for bread, make me bread. When the thirsty cry for water, make me water. When the suffering cry for help, make me help. When the sick cry for healing, make me healing. When the bound cry for freedom, make me freedom. When the outcasts cry for love, make me love. Lord, who is hope, who is bread and water, who is help and healing, who is freedom, and who is love, transform me anew, and so keep me close to you as you transform the world. Amen.